Hello, ISTE. I'm so glad that you've joined me today for this session on making assessment easy with OneNote Class Notebook. Class Notebook is one of my favorite Microsoft EDU tools, and I'm so excited to share more about it with you. I'm Danielle Olson, and I'm the Microsoft Learning Consultant Program Manager and a former high school English teacher. So join me for this really fun look at all of the great things that you can do with Class Notebook. All right, so one of my favorite ways to use Class Notebook for assessment, especially formative assessment, if I don't want to do like a formal assignment, is hitting Control V after I have pasted the share link from a form and then pasting that directly into a page in the quizzes section of my notebook. And then I can use the Class Notebook tab to distribute that page to either individual students or a group of students or across my many notebooks that I have. So I can just click distribute page. Select the section that I would like for this page to go to in my students' notebooks. So quizzes, click distribute. And then that page is going to distribute across to all of my students' notebooks and land in their quizzes section. And then this way, my students are going to be able to navigate to that section, take this quiz, but I'll be able to get all of the results in my forms page in the responses tab. Another way that Class Notebook makes assessing student work really easy is allowing me to review student work right inside of the notebook without having to open each student's notebook. So I can go again to my Class Notebook ribbon and I can click Review Student Work. And I'm going to review the student work inside of this notebook, but I could also do a cross notebook review if I wanted to. So when I click Review Student Work, then I'm going to navigate to where I would like to, you know, which section I want to review that work. So I'm going to click Handouts, which is where I have done I have distributed a page on our Gatsby Day party plan. So I want to review my students' work from their collaboration to plan out a Gatsby Day party. So then I'm going to click Next. And I know that Oscar was one of the planners for his group, but I can also go to Agnes's page and see if she's put anything inside of her work as well. Another thing that I can do when I'm reviewing student work, especially if I haven't used Teams to assign this work, is I can lock the page. So if I don't want students to edit the pages any longer and like the deadline has passed, or maybe it's time for me to do a little general feedback, you know, for that feedback loop before students start working again, then I can, in the Review Student Work tab, I can click Page Locking and I can select all students' pages to lock, or I can, you know, select certain students. But for now, I'm just going to select everybody and I'm going to click Apply. And now what this means is that students are still going to be able to see what's on their pages, but they're not going to be able to make any changes. It's really great for, you know, being able to give that feedback and have students actually look at the feedback, and then you can unlock pages as needed. All right, so I'm going to navigate here to Oscar's page, and I can see that Oscar and his group members have decided on a couple of themes, and this is the theme that they've chosen, and then they've got their jobs, you know, the jobs listed out. So that's awesome there. So I'm going to give him a little bit of feedback, and I can do that by digital inking. So I can grab my pen here, and I can highlight their final theme. I can give Oscar a check plus and say, I can't wait for the party. All right. And then I also can insert a sticker. So this is so fun for students. They love this. And it just gives them something to feel good about. So I can insert a cute sticker to tell them what a great job that they've done. So I've got some choices here. I've got some frames. I have some call out bubbles. I've got, and they're all in Spanish right now. That's fun. If I really think this is out of this world, I'm going to use one of these space stickers. So I'm going to click on that sticker And then that sticker drops in to Oscar's page and I can move it so he can see it and just say, job well done. And then I can move on to the next page. So another really awesome feature of OneNote is the ability to ink, but there's also the ability to insert audio. So if I were teaching math and I was doing linear equation practice, I could use my digital inking, but I could also record audio so students could watch me and listen to me while I delivered this demonstration. So I'm going to go to the insert tab. I'm going to click audio. I'm going to give OneNote access to my microphone. And I'm just going to start putting together a really easy linear equation. X plus 5 equals 10. All right, students, so when you are solving a linear equation, you're going to subtract 5 from each side, and then that's going to give you x. So in this case, x equals 5. And then I'm going to stop. And then what's really awesome is that students can come back, they can see that there's an audio recording here, and they are able to hit play.
And I'm just going to start putting together a really easy linear equation. X plus 5 equals 10.
And you can see as students are listening to the audio is also matching where each of my pen strokes was. And so students can watch as I'm solving the equation, and then they can see each of those pen ticks as well. I also love in OneNote the ability to have a math equation solved for me. So for example, and this is also a great assessment tool as well. So if I write out a math problem, x plus 10 equals 15. Now remember at the beginning, I told you all that I taught English. So math is not one of my strong suits. And so I do very simple linear equations, but I want to show you the coolest tools. So I can select that equation and then I can click on this math button here. And when I click on math, I can see my math equation. If there was something wrong, I could fix it. And I can also ink to math as well. So if I didn't want to have this in digital ink, I could click ink to math. But then I can select an action here and I can solve for x. And look, it tells me that x equals 5, but here's what's really cool. I can also show the steps for solving a linear equation. And I can see that by subtracting 10 from both sides, I get 5. So that's really fabulous as far as math tools go, right? Because I have a math tutor built right into OneNote. But also as a teacher from an assessment base, I can generate a practice quiz for students based off of this equation here that I've used my math tools for. So when I click generate a practice quiz, Microsoft Forms and OneNote are talking to each other. And so I can generate that quiz and I can decide how many questions I want to have. So maybe I want to have 5. And I can click generate quiz. And that practice quiz drops directly here inside of this page. My linear equation practice drops right here inside of this page in Microsoft Teams. In Microsoft OneNote. So what's nice is my students can listen to the audio of me solving this problem. They can work on this problem on their own, and then they can take a practice quiz to see how much more practice they might need. I also love the record audio for student use. So you can see here I have a list of sight words that I have distributed to Corey. And Corey can work on her fluency and her sight words by going to the sight words page, clicking in the recording column beside the word after. She clicks audio after. And then as a teacher, I can go to class notebook, I can review student work, and I can go to Corey's notebook and hear Corey reading her sight words. and I can deliver Corey feedback either as a sticker or as a draw or type it. However I would like to deliver that feedback to Corey, I can do that in Class Notebook. And finally, I love Class Notebook for feedback and assessment because I can easily use Class Notebook and Teams in the assignment feature. So I'm going to create a new assignment and I'm going to add a resource from my Class Notebook that's going to distribute out to all of my students and allow me to grade that assignment right here inside of Teams. So we're going to call this assignment plant cell labeling. And I'm just going to ask students to label the plant cell. And then I'm going to add my resources. And when I click add resources, I'm going to go to Class Notebook. I'm going to look in my content library. I'm going to look in quizzes because that's where I have, I'm going to look in homework because that's where I've got my plant cell model. So I'm going to select the plant cell model and I'm going to click attach. And I'm going to put this in my students' homework section and notice it says that they're going to edit their own copy. So I don't even have to open the notebook. I can simply distribute a page by creating that page as an assignment. I click done. And now once I've decided on a due date, so let's say we're gonna have this due on Monday, I've decided on a due date, I just simply click assign. That assignment gets distributed out to the students who are in my class. And here's what it looks like from the student view. So students will see plant cell labeling. They'll see that it's in their class notebook and they can decide where they want to open their class notebook. So we can just open that in Teams. And here's that plant cell model that students can then add their labels to, and then they can turn it in when they are done. And as a teacher, I can simply click on each of my students, their notebook opens, I can deliver them feedback here or use any of the tools that are available to me in my OneNote notebook to deliver feedback to my students, return the assignment to them, and then move on to the next student. Saving me time, giving students immediate feedback, and I can do this across the devices where I access both Teams and Class Notebook. Thank you so much for joining me for this quick overview of some of the different ways that you can give feedback and also assess your students using OneNote Class Notebook. I hope that you'll head on over to the Microsoft Educator Center at education.microsoft.com, where you will find a wealth of resources for all things Microsoft EDU tools, including courses and learning paths for Class Notebook. I've also sourced through Wakelet some Class Notebook resources, and you can grab those from the Wakelet link that is there. Additionally, when you join the Microsoft Educator Center, you can earn badges and points for taking courses, and you can also put in a promo code so that you can earn a badge and points for today's session. And you can see that here on the slide. Again, thank you so much for coming. I really appreciate it. I hope that you enjoy ISTE. Thank y'all.